In this video, we will cover how to encrypt a USB drive that can be accessed from any Windows computer. Before we begin, it's important to remove any files that you want to keep from the USB drive. This process may remove any files from the USB drive, so if you don't want to lose any files, this is an important step. With that in mind, let's begin. First, enter the USB drive into the computer. Then click on the Windows button and then type Disk Management. The top of the Start menu will show Create and Format Hard Disk Partition. Click on that option. This will open up the Disk Management application. In the Disk Management window, find the disk for the USB drive you want to encrypt. You can identify your USB by looking at the size of the disk on the left that corresponds to your USB drive. For me, this will be drive D. Once you have found your USB drive, check to see that the format of the drive is in TFS. If it is not, right-click the partition and select Format. Click the drop-down next to BIOS System, and then click NTFS. Now click OK, and then click OK again. NTFS is required given a size limit on FAT32 formatted devices. Once the USB is done formatting, it's time to download the encryption software. Go to the VeriQuip website. The link is provided in the description below. Click on the portable version. This is important because we want to keep the encryption software on the USB drive and not install it on the computer. Once the .exe file has been downloaded, go to your downloads folder and run the VeriQuip portable .exe file. This will extract the files for the portable version. Click OK and accept the terms, and then click Next. Click Extract and then click OK. Then click Finish. As you can see, the program files have been extracted in my downloads folder. Now copy the file and paste it into the USB drive. For me, this will be drive D. Now go to the VeriQuip folder and open the VeriQuip.exe file. When the menu becomes available, select Create Volume, then select Create an Encrypted File Container. Then click Next. Click on Standard VeriQuip Volume, then click Next. Now you will have to select the location for the encrypting container. With that in mind, select File, then select the USB drive. Again, this will be drive D for me. Now, put your desired name for the encryption container. You may put whatever name you want here. Then click Save. Now click Next. Now select the encryption type. Note that there are several types, and items with multiple names will have multiple layers of encryption. For this tutorial, we'll pick the default AES. Click Next. Now we will have to select the size of the container, which can be any amount under the remaining space in the drive. For me, I want to fill the remaining space, so I'm going to put 29 gigabytes. Once done, click Next. Now, type in your desired password. It is important that you create a secure, memorable password. If you lose or forget your password, the data on the USB will not be recoverable. Once you have your password typed in, click Next. If you expect to have files larger than 4 gigabytes on your USB drive, select Yes. Otherwise, keep the default. In this next menu, we are creating a unique and random hash that will be used to encrypt the data. For this to be truly random, it uses mouse movement. With that in mind, move your mouse around until the bar is full, then select Format. Now the process will begin to encrypt your drive. This may take several hours depending on your CPU and the size of the USB. Once the encryption file has been complete, select Exit. Now I will show you how to access your encrypted USB drive. First, click Select File button, and then locate the encrypted file container you created earlier. Click on the container, and then click Open. Now, click on a drive letter that you want the encrypted data to be temporarily assigned to. For me, I selected H. Now click Mount. Then, type in your password you created earlier, and then click OK. Now, you can go into the drive you selected and access the encrypted drive. When you are done, go back to the VeriQuip software and then select Dismount All. And now you can remove the USB drive. I will cover how to access the USB drive if you plug it into any computer. I'll go ahead and plug the USB back in. I'll then go into the USB drive and open the VeriQuip folder. I'll then reopen the VeriQuip.exe application. Now, follow the steps mentioned earlier to access the drive. If you enjoyed this video, you should definitely check out this one. Thanks for watching.